from the Department of Health, as mentioned, really, because of El Nino, our heat index has been shooting up to as high as 50, which are danger levels in terms of what the human body can take. So reminders to everyone, first of all, see yung mga high risk, tinatawag natin, the senior citizens, actually up to 50 or above, and very young children are what we call high risk sa effects of this high heat index. So pag nag-danger or nag-orange level yung heat indices, very important, huwag ma-expose. So this is an exposure illness. So kung hindi ka lalabas sa very hot areas, yung risk mo bababa. So the other high-risk people are people who work outside. So at also who do sports, yung recreation. So kailangan conscious sila if they can avoid doing recreational activities during the times 10 a.m. to 4 p.m. Mas maganda kasi dun yung high risk na magkaroon ka ng heat cramps, heat exhaustion, and can lead to heat stroke and death, no? Pwedeng mamatay. So far, we have been monitoring the heat-related illnesses, although hindi ito reportable, no? Kasi many of them recover. But we have in our records hospitals that have reported 34 cases of heat-related illness na naitalaga na sa iba't ibang parte ng Pilipinas. Majority of this happened actually in a place in Mindanao. And then there are reported deaths pero questionable pa. So I cannot verify that people have died. But what I can tell you scientifically is we really can die from heat illness. So ang reminders ko is the first aid for people experiencing heat cramps. You have to stop your activity. Kung ikaw ay outside working or ikaw ay outside doing sports, once you develop heat cramps, yung pamumulikat ng muscle, you need to stop your activity. Kailangan mong umalis dun sa area where you are and transfer to an area na cool. And then the next one, you may have to remove your clothes. Baka naka-jacket ka, baka naka-sweatsuit ka. Remove your clothes para mag-evaporate. And then use basang bimpo and then hydrate. Now, ang tip ko sa hydration is very simple. People in sports have learned this already. They actually have created commercial sports drink. Pero sa totoo lang, yung sports drink, pwedeng gawin ng anyone. Kumuha ka ng isang basong tubig, kumuha ka ng a pinch of salt, at ilagay mo doon sa basong tubig. Meron na yung electrolytes because the salt has sodium, so potassium, and all iodine, kasi iodized ang salt natin. So actually, you can do that with a pinch of salt. Huwag naman isang kutsara. It's just a pinch of salt. And that's enough. Kasi pag ang sweat natin, meron ding sodium. Yung cause ng cramps is really the lack of sodium sa body. So ang recommendation ko, very simple first aid. The next one is prevention. So wide-brim hat, pagkalalabas ka, you need to go out in an activity. Wide-brim hat to protect you from the sun. Umbrella, di ba? Yung suot mo dapat yung tamang attire for very loose clothing, cotton usually, and to make sure mas maganda kung white or lighter color so it can reflect sunlight and heat para hindi nakikip yung heat sa katawan mo. The best is really if you start to feel cramps, dehydration, is to get out of the environment. So pumasok sa lilim, pumunta sa aircon na kwarto, at mag-hydrate, mag-rehydrate. So ang key dito, reminder and prevention. The second one I will talk about is really because of high heat, mabilis mapanis ang pagkain. So be careful with food that we eat because in a couple of hours, panis na yan. The only advice I will give is pag meron kayong nakain na delikado, put aside a little so we can analyze it. So we will know what microbe or bacteria ang naging etiology o cause ng inyong pagtatae. Mas madadalian yung doktor at ospital sa pagpapagamot sa inyo with the proper antibiotics if we have a sample of yung nag-cause ng food poisoning, lalo na kung maramihan yung kumain nun. But just put aside, wag itapon lahat, lagay sa isang lalagyang plastic bag at dalin sa hospital para ma-analyze din namin.